Well, Shay, it's that time of year. You've been waiting for so long to graduate. I'm very proud of you, I love you, and I wish the best for you. And it's good to have two nurses in the family. Bye.
Congratulations, Nurse Haley. We love you.
Congratulations, Jolandis. I'm so proud of you. Good luck in the future. Love you.
Good job, Shay.
Kaylee Kate, we're so proud of you. You're our oldest granddaughter, our first granddaughter graduate.
And we love you so, and we're so proud of you.
Hi, Hannah. Congratulations on your graduation. It is a well-deserved success. I am so proud of you. I am so happy for you.
Congratulations, Haley. Love you so much. I'm super, super proud of you. Sad that I can't be there to support you. You're going to be a great nurse. Love you.
We love you.
Congratulations, Rachel.
Hi, Josefina. I just want to congratulate you on everything that you've done. I'm very proud of you, and you're going to make a wonderful nurse. I love you so much.
Congratulations, Rachel!
Hey, sis. I just wanted to congratulate you on your graduation from nursing school. I'm so proud of you and all that you have accomplished, and you will make an amazing nurse. Love you.
Congratulations, Adebisi Makinde-Oshola. You worked very hard and you did it. We are so happy for you. To the world's newest nurse, salute, Oluwale Makinde Odushola.
Nurse Mindy Martinson.
Congratulations!
Congratulations,
Rachel.
Congratulations, Raquel Welch. Just want to congratulate you on a well-done job. You've accomplished what you wanted to, and only 29 years old. Your family should be so proud of you. Good luck, dear.
Yay, Shay!
Congrats, we love you!
Congratulations, Mom. And that's a wrap.
Graduates, faculty, families, friends, and distinguished guests, welcome to the commencement ceremony for the class of spring semester 2022. Most of you may not recognize my surroundings or even the wall behind me. Unlike many other colleges and universities who host graduation ceremonies within ivy-covered towers of learning, Nightingale College does not have a traditional campus. But that doesn't make your achievements any less real. Perhaps you graduates have explained to your family and friends, unfamiliar with the college, that you attend nursing school without ever setting foot in a classroom. For many of us associated with Nightingale College, this room in the Operations Support Center in Salt Lake City is nearly as unfamiliar to us as it is to you wherever you're watching. Although a traditional college environment might include lectures, rote memorization, sports teams, and bad cafeteria food, Nightingale College's virtual learning format is different. For our learners who come from nearly 40 states, online learning requires a tremendous initiative to be successful. Graduates, we congratulate you. We hope you are as proud of yourselves as we are of you. Not only have you crammed your heads and hearts full of the skills, knowledge, and values necessary for nursing success, you've done it largely on your own. You have navigated virtual communication with your professors, created elaborate color-coded study schedules, and formed instant friendships with your classmates. Let's face it, if you never hear the acronym HESI again, it will be too soon. You survived entire courses on caffeine alone. You have traveled short or long distances for your clinical assignments. Many of you have balanced all of these demands with other priorities like work and family. Some of you have experienced personal hardships. You may have redone assignments, exams, or even entire courses to get there, but you didn't give up. That tenacity is what got you here today. your ability to keep going, even when you're overwhelmed and at the end, and the end seems so far out of reach, has not only gotten you a degree, it will help you pass the NCLEX, and it will make you a strong, capable nurse. Although there were some moments when you weren't sure you'd survive until next week, let alone graduate, you pushed through fatigue, fear, and failure on your way to success. That's the caliber of human and nurse that you are. You'll take the lessons you've learned here into your profession. You'll ask the difficult questions. You'll lose patience, you'll get frustrated, you'll make mistakes. You'll laugh and you'll cry. But through it all, you'll be true to yourself. We know it hasn't been easy. All of us here today, virtually and in person, are so proud of you. It is my honor to acknowledge the presence of our distinguished leadership and faculty. We are honored to have with us Mikhail Schneider, President and CEO, Jonathan Tanner, Executive Vice President and Chief Opportunity Officer, Thomas Reams, Executive Vice President and Chief Financial Officer, Dr. Jeffrey Olson, Vice President of Learner Experience and Provost, Dr. Audrey Auer, Director of Nursing Education Services, Gina Reese, Vice President of Enrollment Management, and Tyler Asman, Vice President of Institutional Effectiveness. We would also like to recognize the faculty and staff who are here and online with us to celebrate this graduating class. We recognize your tireless work and contribution to the success of our learners and graduates. At this time, we would also like to acknowledge all the family and friends who have supported our graduates through this rigorous program and continue to support them today. Lastly, it is my distinct privilege to welcome all our graduating learners to this commencement ceremony to honor you and your academic achievements. We wish to recognize a few members of the graduating class who have held distinguished roles or outstanding achievements during their time with Nightingale College. I would like to recognize the Learner Ambassadors. The Learner Ambassadors are the voice of the learners. The learners in these positions represent their cohort and college-wide committees and serve as liaisons between the learner population and faculty, staff, and college administration. It is my pleasure to recognize and thank the Spring 2022 Cohort Learner Ambassadors, Jessica Fisher, Ralph Nanalis, and Denise Rourke. Thank you, Jessica, Ralph, and Denise, for serving in this leadership capacity. I've had the honor to work with these learners in this capacity, and I know that they will serve as future leaders in the nursing field. Nightingale College would also like to recognize a special group of learners graduating today. These learners heard and answered our nation's call to duty. We gratefully recognize our learners and those who have supported a learner who served in the armed forces. Members of the armed forces have a long-standing tradition of carrying a special coin called a challenge coin. Challenge coins symbolize unit identity and esprit de corps. We have presented our veteran and military learners with the Nightingale College Commemorative Veteran Alumni Coin for excellence and achievement in nursing. These learners are Joseph W. Bertoli, United States Navy, Kayla Dolan, United States Air Force, and Joseph Dunham, United States Army National Guard. Just as you answered the call to armed service, you now answer the call to service in nursing. Today, it is our honor to induct you into the ranks of the Nightingale College Veteran Alumni. These courageous learners will be recognized in the reading of the graduates and honors. It is also important for us to recognize the unusual circumstances under which this class is graduating. 2 years ago, the world was thrown into a global pandemic, the likes of which current generations have never seen. Each new variant is faced with fatigue and frustration. But rather than putting off school, hiding, or using this as an excuse to not move forward with your dream, this class worked tirelessly to join the ranks of first-line caregivers. This reflects the selflessness of caring for others with confidence and courage that is part of what drives you to be nurses. We honor the memories of the victims of the pandemic and celebrate your efforts and your willingness to heal an ailing nation. While the pandemic has largely been contained, We recognize that your willingness to pursue a career in healthcare at a time when it was so uncertain. For every graduating cohort, the faculty selects a distinguished learner to receive the Flame Forward Award. This award goes to the learner who, throughout their tenure with us, has embraced what we at Nightingale College call evolvitude by embodying the college's core values, striving to elevate to new aspirational heights, and acting in accordance with our foundational principles. Thank you for your dedication to evolvitude and for serving as living examples of these principles. This award will be delivered to the honoree, and as we say in times of celebration at Nightingale College, flame forward. Academic honors are achieved by reaching a grade point average of 3.65 or higher at degree completion. Acknowledgement of those achieving these honors will be announced with the degree award portion of the ceremony. The learner who achieved the highest GPA is recognized as the cohort valedictorian, with ties broken by looking at standardized nursing test scores. I am honored to announce this graduating class's valedictorian.
Hello, everybody. My name is Casey Munsell. Hello, family, friends, classmates, teachers. We're done. I can hardly even believe it. I'm halfway expecting school to be starting up again tomorrow. We've had pretty much no life these past couple of years, as you all know. And it's very true what they say, nursing school is hard. We've all given up a lot to be here, but we got here and we passed the finish line and we're going to be fantastic nurses. We are a unique class of nurses. We started this journey when the world was normal. For me, I started in January of 2020 and then in February the entire world shut down. We've experienced things a little bit differently than the classes before us and hopefully the classes after us. Our skills labs looked a little bit different than most. We put catheters in water bottles. We made makeshift IV poles out of lamps in our homes. We put IVs in our loved ones. Thank you guys. We are so sorry. And we all got a very creepy head in the mail to practice our skills on. We all sat through VCBCs and met each other through a computer screen before ever seeing each other in person. Despite all that, and despite COVID and having to learn in a very unconventional way, we've all somehow managed to make it out the other side. I think a nursing diagnosis that applies to us all is acute stress related to nursing school, as evidenced by HESIs, long clinical hours, and lack of sleep. This journey has been full of tears, laughs, and fear. We're going into the real world now, and that is scary. We're the nurses now. We're the ones patients are going to look to when they're scared and they have questions. We're the ones responsible for patients' lives. We have the knowledge and we have the compassion, and now it's time to put it to good use. Without a strong support system, it's impossible to make it through this. I want to say thank you to my support system, Mom, Dad, Raymond, Aubrey. I wouldn't have been able to make it through this without you guys. My fiancé Raymond and I did this together, and we're graduating together. And we decided to have a baby in the middle of it. I'm so proud of us. And I've also made lifelong friends here. Ralph, Mercedes, thank you guys for our late night study sessions and for keeping me sane. I'm so proud of all of us. Everyone here has their own lives and their own hurdles that they've crossed to make it here. But guess what? We got here. We're done. We all have a Bachelor's of Science in Nursing. I want to say thank you to all the professors I've had here at Nightingale. You've all been so amazing and have taught me so much. Now it's time to go crush our NCLEX and get our $200 back from the school. Thank you. Congratulations, everybody.
At this time, I would also like to invite the graduates and their pinners to stand before their families and friends. Pinners, please have the pin ready to bestow upon your graduate.
The tradition of the nursing pin and the ceremonial pinning originated in the 1860s at the Nightingale School of Nursing at St. Thomas Hospital in London. Having been recently awarded the Red Cross of St. George for her selfless service to the injured and dying in the Crimean War, Florence Nightingale chose to extend the honor to her most outstanding graduate nurses by presenting each of them with a medal for excellence. The nursing pin remains a symbolic medal of honor. Nurses honor both the miracle of life and the finality of death. They respect and honor an individual's right to enter into life safely and to die with dignity. They honor their patients' rights to continue or refuse medical care, even when they personally disagree with the decision. The pinning ceremony is therefore so much more than an event to mark the completion of nursing school. It is a beautiful rite of passage into the profession and serves as a reminder to all of us of nursing's well-founded historic promise to serve the infirm and promote the health of every individual. Pinners, please attach the Nightingale pin to your learner. Graduates, please remain standing after you have been pinned. Your pinner may be seated. Candidates, please light your lamps and stand with them, facing your family and friends. The lighting of the lamp is a tradition representing the honor and rite of passage into the profession of nursing. Florence Nightingale is known as the Lady of the Lamp. Her oil lamp lit the corridors where she cared for the wounded during the Crimean War. The lamp became a symbol of Florence Nightingale's values: comfort and kindness, gentleness and courage, and an unwavering devotion to duty. Today, the graduates light the nursing lamp as a demonstration of confidence, competence, and compassion, and as a promise to meet every professional challenge with utmost skill, sound clinical judgment, and inexhaustible caring. So, as the lighting of the nursing lamp resonates in the hearts of all professional nurses, may these new graduates make their own lasting and powerful impact on healthcare in our communities, our states, our nation, and beyond. We invite you to place your lamp somewhere in your home and leave it lit overnight to glow so that all may know of your accomplishment. Now, will all nurses, including the graduates, please repeat the nursing pledge? The text will be shown on your screen.
With full knowledge of the responsibilities I am undertaking, I pledge to care for my patients with all of the knowledge, skills, and understanding that I possess, without regard to race, color, creed, politics, or social status. I will spare no effort to conserve meaningful life, to alleviate suffering, and to promote health. I will refrain from any action which might be harmful to the quality of life or health of those I care for. I will respect at all times the dignity and religious beliefs of the patients under my care, and hold in professional confidence all the personal information entrusted to me. I will endeavor to keep my professional knowledge and skills at the highest level and give my support and cooperation to all members of the healthcare team with full awareness of my qualifications and limitations. I will do my utmost to maximize the potential of the nursing profession and to uphold and advance its standards.
Thank you, nurses. Particularly in this time of pandemic, we honor your service. You may be seated. Dr. Audrey Auer, our Director of Nursing Education Services, will now address you.
If you were to ask me as a young person what I wanted to be in life, I would tell you I wanted to be a writer. I was really fascinated with people's stories and their experiences in life. I graduated from college with degrees in journalism and sociology, and I learned a lot about how to glean the story of whatever event was at hand and write about it. I hadn't thought about becoming a nurse until a few years later when one of my own children was born with a life-threatening illness. I guess you could say I experienced the calling. I invite each of you to reflect on your calling, because I believe each of you has had one. Here is how I went from becoming a normal person to becoming a nurse. From the perspective of a parent with an ill child, I felt for the first time that sense of vulnerability, fear, and helplessness. We were transferred from the local hospital to a special children's hospital in a distant city. During the period of initial diagnosis and treatment, I became aware of the importance of this person, the nurse. Each shift changed, I wondered who would be in charge of our care. Would it be someone I knew or an unfamiliar face? I looked to this person for information, education, reassurance, as a person I could trust. I wondered if I could read the expression on their face to interpret whether the news was good or bad. I recognized this person, this nurse, oftentimes a stranger, was so important to me, my child, and my family. Over the next 5 years, I managed to enroll in a local nursing program and graduate. A few weeks before I was scheduled to take my state boards, better known as the NCLEX exam, my son experienced an exacerbation of his illness that required us to relocate back to that distant state, close to the children's hospital. After passing my state boards, I became employed at that large teaching hospital in the Midwest. After spending some time pondering the years I spent as a staff nurse, I would like to share some lessons with you as you begin your journey as a nurse. These are not the usual stories of babies being born or grandparents dying. The first lesson is to observe the details. In the first year after graduation, I worked on a medical floor. This unit happened to be a catch-all for various admissions, and many came from the emergency department. There was a doctor's room at the end of the hallway that had tables along the wall, and chained to the wall were what we called physician's desk references, or PDRs. They were big blue reference books. On the night shift, I would spend time looking up diagnoses of my patients in these big blue books. One evening, a patient was admitted from the emergency room who had recently been released after being incarcerated for several years. He presented with shortness of breath, and in the report, I was told he was manipulative and had a lower than normal intelligence. I entered the room and did my initial assessment, where he was very talkative and somewhat inappropriate. His condition was stable, yet he continued to put the call light on over and over, so I would come to the room and chat with him. After several conversations with him, the other staff noted that he was taking up a lot of my time. The last time I entered the room, he said the words to me, "I can't breathe very well." So I repeated my assessment and noted his lung sounds had deteriorated a little bit. I called his physician and reported the findings, but during that phone call, he put his call light on again. I heard him yell, and I told the doctor, "Hold on." I put the phone down and went to the room where the patient said to me, "They only gave me 20 milligrams of medication, and I usually get 60 milligrams with my asthma attack." Then the patient coded and was unresponsive. We proceeded to resuscitate him, and I was so grateful I listened and paid attention to the details with this challenging patient. The lesson I learned was to pay attention and not make any assumptions. Always ask your patients about their treatment. Lesson number two, expect the unexpected. For about 5 years, I worked on the IV transfusion team. As nurses, our responsibility was to administer blood transfusions across the hospital. It might be a routine blood transfusion, or we might be called for emergency rapid infusion of blood products. One evening, a stat order was received from the emergency department. Two of us nurses grabbed our carts and quickly pushed them down to the emergency department. There was a young man in his 20s laying on the table who had received a large stab wound to his chest. A large medical team assembled and attempted to perform CPR, and we administered around 20 units of blood products. Efforts to save his life went on for about 45 minutes. As a last attempt to revive him, the medical doctor asked everyone to step away from the table, and he reached inside the stab wound to attempt cardiac massage. This was not successful, and the time of death was declared. Everyone left the room, and I proceeded with the duties of collecting the empty blood infusion bags, recording the numbers and blood types, and cleaned up. I realized at some point I was alone in the room with the remains of this young man naked on the table. His body was muscular and youthful. He had perfectly formed rows in his hair and beautiful black braids. The expression on his face was peaceful under the fluorescent lights. I realized I'd seen death in those who were elderly and sick, but had never seen a perfectly healthy person deceased. In the silence, I felt the incongruence of death in this young man. About 8 months later, on the front page of our city's newspaper was a picture of a woman crying. The headlines below were, "Chicago Mom Attends Trial for Her Son in the City." I recognized it was the patient's mother who had come to attend her son's killer's trial. Looking at her picture, I related to her as a mom, and I wanted to say to her that he was okay. I was there and he was peaceful. I saw the peace in his face. The third lesson is to witness the love. I worked in an intensive care unit where a patient from the Middle East was there in his early 30s, and had come for treatment for his cancer. While receiving chemotherapy, he experienced an infection in his bloodstream that caused his organs to shut down. He was in the ICU for several weeks, and once he was off the ventilator, he was able to speak. He was respectful, but used few words. I only ever saw him in a hospital gown, but I observed the traditional white robe and colored headdress in the closet. At the bedside was a Middle Eastern woman wearing jeans and a jersey. They didn't speak much to each other, and I noticed she spent most of her time reading. One day I entered the room and the patient was tearful. I completed my morning assessment and asked him if he was in pain, and he indicated no. I asked if I could do anything to help, and he again said no. The woman soon arrived with a backpack, suitcase, and a winter coat. She was dressed for a trip. She stated that she was his sister and also a medical student, and she needed to return to Harvard University to continue her studies. I turned to the patient and said, "It must be hard to see your sister leave." He replied with tears in his eyes and hands on his chest and said, "She is my heart." As you begin practicing as a nurse, you learn every day and through everyday experience how to be a better nurse. You will also learn much about people and humanity. Please remember to observe the details, expect the unexpected, and witness love.
Thank you, Audrey, for those wonderful words. And now we will read the names and honors of our graduates.
Gabriela Agundez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Hannah Appa, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Haley Baldwin, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Rachel Barba, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Sherry Barber, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Jennifer Bartlemy, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Alexis Bennett, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Joseph Bertoli, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude, United States Navy. Stephanie Bird, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Melissa Bolander, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Taryn Branson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Sharon Brownlee, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Diana Bryson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Ramey Burton, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Megan Cannon, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Mariah Captain, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Christine Jadel Carriaga, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Nicole Carroll, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Madison Cecil, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Balbir Dami, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Jennifer Diaz, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Kayla Dolan, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude, United States Air Force. Savannah Duncan, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Joseph Dunham, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, United States Army National Guard. Anna Duong, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Mariah Farnes, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Jessica Fitcher, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude, Runner Ambassador. Raymond Fox, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Teresa Fox, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Fatima Franklin, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Savannah Fredericks, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Leonette De Fuentes de la Torres, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Kylie Gallegos, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Zacharias Gebra, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Stacy Hansen, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Tamarisk Hansen, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Abigail Harmson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Jacqueline Harris, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Kayla A. Hatfield, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Kylie Houston, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Stephanie Einick, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Tajane Johnson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Francisca Joshua, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Marinella Justo, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Diana Kamami, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Caitlin Keyser, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Cameron Kendrick, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Rebecca Kirby, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Shella Corticas, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Josefina P. Coons, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Dallin Langford, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Adebisi Makinde Odusola, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Mercedes Martinez, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Mindy Martinson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Marley Masterson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Patrice McCarter, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Caitlin Morris, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Tamara Mori, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Casey Munsell, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude, valedictorian. Guli Mursalova, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Ralph Nanalis, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, learner ambassador. Shanetta Newburn, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Patience Odong, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Susan M. Owen, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Ryan Palmer, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Janice Piscozzo, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Tika Rizal, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude, Flame Forward Award. Denise Rourke, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude, Learner Ambassador. Gwendolyn Robards, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Yolandis Sanimaterio, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Brianna F. Smith Hollowell, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Michelle Sorensen, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Analia Soto, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Jason Stevens, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Paula Stevens, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Aaron L. Tannehill, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Marlene Tarango, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Kimberly Thompson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Natasha L. Thompson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Jalene Timoteo, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Lori Torok, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Nadine Tremblay, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Jasmine Villanueva, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Abby Waldorf, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Amber Watson, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, magna cum laude. Sean White, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Kali Williams, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, cum laude. Oceana Williams, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Shaylin Williams, Bachelor of Science in Nursing. Catherine Zudor, Bachelor of Science in Nursing, summa cum laude. Jennifer M. Fuller, Practical Nursing Diploma, High Honors. Bridget Lovato, Practical Nursing Diploma, High Honors. Ingrid V. Sanchez, Practical Nursing Diploma.
Please welcome to the stage Dr. Jeffrey Olson, Vice President of Learner Experience and Provost of Nightingale College, for closing remarks.
Good afternoon. Walt Disney once said that a beautiful tomorrow is only a dream away. Well, we all dream of a better life and a better world. However, dreaming alone cannot create that beauty. For much effort and dedication of many must go into making it a reality. And that is why we built Nightingale College, on the foundation of an unyielding belief that better health and better humanity will lead to a better world for everyone. And better health and better humanity start with me and you. For as human beings, we all have an incredible capacity to evolve and elevate ourselves, to actualize and transcend our individual egos, hence allowing the beauty of our true nature to shine into this world. Candidates, however arduous this journey of personal, educational, and professional evolution has been, here you are, a better, more elevated human being. And that is absolutely something to be celebrated. As you haven't gotten here alone, though, I would like to recognize and thank all the people who were instrumental in materializing your dream. Parents and grandparents, thank you for always being there and cheerleading your learner on their way to success. Spouses and life partners, thank you for selflessly sacrificing your time and energy to ensure that your learner was well-fed and groomed throughout this journey. Children, thank you for keeping quiet just enough to allow your mom or dad to complete their school assignments. I hope you are inspired by and proud of your amazing parents. Friends, thank you for not unfriending your learner on social media, even when they were missing in action for long periods of time. Faculty and staff, thank you for your tremendous support and guidance of our learners through this extremely demanding endeavor. And finally, candidates, thank you for pushing and elevating yourselves to new heights. Growth is never easy, but you have indisputably taken a giant leap toward realizing your true potential, toward being able to heal and change the lives of others for the better, toward improving your families, communities, and ultimately the world. And this step is just the beginning. As you move forward, I invite you to commit to being the best version of yourself, to embody deliberate evolvement and growth, and still be grounded in kindness and humility, to contribute meaningfully to the vision of a better world, and to ultimately self-govern, self-actualize, and self-transcend, to act with integrity, transparency, responsibility, and inclusivity, and to always emanate love, trust, and gratitude. So go out into the world, pass the NCLEX exam, if you haven't already, and keep learning through formal and continuing education. Be proud to be a nurse and of all the good you do. Be a true agent of health. Pay forward the kindness, love, and support you have received, and help make others' dreams come true. Carry both the light of Florence Nightingale's lamp as you continue learning and growing. And most importantly, never stop dreaming of impossible things and making them a reality.
Dr. Olson, the faculty of Nightingale College hereby assert that the candidates listed have completed the requirements to earn the Diploma of Practical Nursing or the Bachelor of Science in Nursing. It is my pleasure to present to you the Spring 2022 graduating cohort for degree conferral.
Candidates, please stand before your family and friends. By the powers vested in me by the Board of Managers of Nightingale College and upon recommendation of the faculty, I hereby confer upon you the Practical Nursing Diploma or degree of Bachelor of Science in Nursing as appropriate, with all the responsibilities and privileges thereof. You may now move the tassel of your cap from the right to the left, symbolizing your passage from learner to graduate. And this concludes our ceremony. We invite you to take lots of pictures today and share them with us on our Facebook page and other social media. Use hashtag Nightingale College and hashtag Nightingale 2022. Congratulations, graduates.
Oh, baby, there ain't no mountain high enough. Ain't no valley low enough. Ain't no river wide enough to keep me from getting to you, baby.
Remember the day I set you free? I told you you could always count on me, darling. From that day on, I made a vow I'll be there when you want.
Congratulations, Dajanae! You did it! We talked about this as kids, and you did it. Of course you did. I'm so proud of you. I love you so much. It's up from here.
Congratulations!
Still I run toward the wind.
Congratulations, Abby!
Congratulations, Abby!
We love you so much and we are so proud of you.
Congratulations, Mama!
Congratulations, Kayla. We love you. We're so proud of you.
Congratulations, Tajanae. You earned it.
Hi, Kayla. Happy graduation. I hope you're so proud of yourself. You deserve every bit of this moment. I love you. Congratulations.
Congratulations, Taj.
Good evening. I wanted to give a huge shout out to my niece, Tajanae Johnson. So very proud of you. So excited about your future. You got this.
Congratulations, Haley. All of your hard work has paid off. You're a very beautiful young lady and deserve the best.
Good luck in the future. We are very proud of you and we love you very much.
Abby, I'm very proud of you and I love you so much. Good job on doing something that you really wanted.
Hi, Haley. Congratulations. We're proud of you and grateful for your example and we wish you the best.
Congratulations. We love you.
Congratulations, Susan, Maria, Wynn. You made it, Mama. You did. You did. You come in. So long. So long. Sorry.
You're very, your hard work paid off and you're fulfilling your dreams. And we're so proud of you for all the work you've done. And, you're not one to quit. You kept walking forward, one step in front of the other, and you accomplished what you're trying to do. Your dreams are coming true, so we love you.
We love you. You did it, mija. Congratulations.
Yep. Congratulations, Kayla. We are so proud, and we love you.
Congratulations, Tajanae. I am so proud of you and so happy for you. Love you.
Congratulations. We're so proud of you.
We are. Great job. Enjoy another day.
Congratulations, Mommy.
We knew you can do it.
Congratulations, Mommy.
We knew you can do it.
You earned it.
You did it, Hannah. We are so very proud of you. This was not an easy journey at all, but you did it, and you did it beautifully, wonderfully, and we are so beyond proud of you and cannot wait to see everything that you will continue to do because we know you'll continue to do great things. We love you.
Thank you, Mimi.
I love you.
I love you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Blow her kiss.
Anna Upper, congratulations on your successful graduation to become a registered nurse. God bless you and God bless the nursing profession.
Hi, Sherry. I love you so much. You finally did it. You're all done. Congratulations. I love you.
Definitely. Make your lifelong dream come true. You go, girl. You'll be the best nurse ever.
Hi, Shaylin. I just wanted to let you know how very proud I am of you. All the hard work and everything you've been doing is paying off. All the late nights crying and so on and so forth. Be all worth it in the long run. Good luck with the rest of your nursing career.
Congratulations, Tajanae. I love you so much and I'm so grateful and blessed to have seen you walk across the stage and get to see you enjoy another graduation day. A little note that I want you to keep in mind is to take pride in how far you've come. Have faith in how far you can go, but don't forget to enjoy the journey on the way. You are so beautiful. You are so blessed. Enjoy everything. I love you.
Congratulations, baby. We are so proud of you.
We love you.
Jay, congrats on your RN degree. I know you worked so hard for this, and I'm so proud of you. Love you.
Congratulations, Abby. We're so proud of you.
Hello, Hannah. Just want to say congratulations on your graduation. We love you so much. We are so proud of you. Congratulations, baby girl. We love you. We love you. We love you so much. Mwah.
ship belongs and you can get off.